Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.2, Problem 7. This is Section 3.2, Problem number 7. It says Jim works at Market Basket, New Bedford. He keeps track of the information shown below. Which one do you think would have the largest standard deviation, and which one do you think would have the smallest standard deviation? So we have the number of eggs in a dozen, the number of broken eggs in a dozen, and the amount of money spent by shoppers. So again, we want to determine which one of these lists of data that you could collect would have the largest standard deviation and which one would be the smallest. So standard deviation is a measure of dispersion or a measure of how spread out the data is. So the data that has the most spread out, would have the largest standard deviation. Now keep that in mind when you consider the different lists. The number of eggs in a dozen, it's the same for every dozen, it's 12. So the standard deviation would be zero. There's no spread in the data at all. The number of broken eggs in a dozen, it's usually zero, but every now and then you have one or two broken eggs. So you'd have a tiny standard deviation. The first one should be a standard deviation of zero. And the last one, the amount of money spent by shoppers, well, that can range quite a bit. Some shoppers come in and spend maybe, you know, $20 or $30, whereas other shoppers might spend $200, $300 or more. So the data that's going to be most spread out is going to come from how much money is spent by shoppers. So that will be largest standard deviation. And the number of eggs in a dozen would certainly be the smallest. That would have a standard deviation of zero because it's the same answer every time, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12. So that would be smallest standard deviation. And then number of broken eggs in a dozen would be small, but not as small as the number of eggs in a dozen.